We're gonna batch a bunch of Instagram Reels content.
This is my hack on how I upload it to Instagram Reels and how I remove the TikTok logo.
Here are some tips that I have for you. Guys, welcome back to my channel. It has been a very long time since I last vlogged, but this video is a special one. I'm gonna be taking you behind the scenes on me batching my Instagram Reel content, and on top of that, I'm gonna show you a little hack that I use to come up with content really fast and also just upload the damn thing on my Instagram, because I posted this IG Reel and it took me forever, and I feel like I have maybe found a way around just being a little bit faster when it comes to production of Instagram Reels and all of that. And I do have to say, I'm pretty impressed with just IG Reels in general. I think that because it is a new feature on Instagram and they're trying to compete hard with TikTok, they are very, very loose with that algorithm. Like, I posted one video and this video had 50,000 views on it versus my IGTVs, which have like literally half of that. And so I really think that I'm onto something, and I think that if you're using IG Reels, you're onto something as well. I think it's a really great way to expand your reach, especially during this time when Instagram is really pushing IG Reels out there. If you check out your explore page, you're gonna see tons of IG Reels, and that's kind of how I know that Instagram is really loving hard on the IG Reel thing. So you definitely wanna hop on the little bandwagon if you can. I do this video for you mainly because I wanna show you kind of my workflow of how I'm batching this, and also just my learning lessons that I've gotten so far and the way that I do it. And I'm sure that in the future, I will post a more formal video about Instagram Reels and actually using the platform in depth, showing you guys step by step. But for now, I would rather you guys just have the information on how I'm doing it so that you guys don't have to like DM me about it, and I can just show you this video and you can learn and just see the behind the scenes of my workflow. And so if you're interested in that, then let's get started, because my hair is still a little bit wet. I have no makeup on, and I'm still wearing like the t-shirt that I wear to bed. And so I'm gonna get changed, I'm gonna get ready, and we're gonna batch a bunch of Instagram Reels content. All right, guys, I am back. My makeup is done. My hair is blow dried and straightened. We're gonna go for a straight look today. And my office is semi set up. So let me just show you the behind the scenes of what it looks like to film a video like this and also batch content for IG Reels. I've actually never done this before. I've never batched content for Instagram Reels. So we'll see how today goes, but I wanna at least show you kind of the behind the scenes. All right, so what you're seeing now is my office. It's super messy. It's actually a lot messier than I make it out to be, but like there's literally like soil bags on the floor. I haven't cleaned out my garbage in a while. Another soil bag there, you know, plant stuff. It's a mess. But what you have to know is on my screen, and this is a 49-inch monitor, link in the description box below if you are crazy like me and you want to have a big screen. But I have my Airtable, and I will do a video in the future about how I set up my Airtable and stuff, my new way of batching content and my new way of seeing my content plan. But essentially, I have the script for the video that you're seeing right now. This is basically just making sure that I don't miss anything that I want to say in this particular video. So I have it right in front of me. I've also got my outfit changes. So a few tops over here, some sweaters and all that, because I do want to plan like 5 IG Reels at least. And the outfit that I'm wearing right now, like, it's usually like a pretty easy outfit to change out of. Like, I literally am wearing shorts right now, and I don't really plan on changing the bottoms unless the IG Reel shows the bottoms, and maybe I'll throw on some leggings. But that's kind of how I batch. And then let me show you some of the equipment. So going back to the office, here I've got my YouTube camera, and it's on a tripod. Everything will be in the link in the description box below, but this isn't set up correctly. I still have to like adjust it and everything, but this is gonna be the camera that's gonna help me film the behind the scenes of this video, and it's gonna be my B-roll. And then over here, this is my stand for my actual iPhone, where I'm gonna be filming the IG Reels on. So this is also an amazing tool. I've talked about it in the past, but it's essentially just a camera tripod. I'll put it against the the door so you can see it better. But this is where you would put your camera, and you can adjust it and then make it like turn. I'm not going to do it now because I only have one hand to operate on. And then there's like three different heights that you can set it at. It's amazing and it's super, super sturdy. And this is kind of how I film my IG Reel content. All right, so I have my phone in front of me, and the first thing that I'm going to do before I even start is I'm actually going to go to my TikTok. And what I've been doing lately is I have been perusing around TikTok, not just personally, but also for business. And what I'll specifically do is I'll go through the TikTok feed and like any videos that I think I could recreate from a business perspective, because my niche is in business. And so what I'll look at is I'll go to my profile on TikTok, and then I will click that button where you can show all the videos that you've liked in the past. I actually didn't even know that that existed. I didn't know that TikTok actually saves and archives the things that you like, because I know Instagram doesn't do that. So what I was doing before is I would actually put videos into my favorites folder, and then that's where I would see or save a lot of videos that I wanted to take inspiration from, that I wanted to recreate eventually on my own TikTok, but now I'm probably going to be focusing more on Instagram Reels. But now I kind of look through the likes. So just so you know, like if you like something, you can actually see it. I had no idea. And then these are just some of the videos that I've liked that I really want to recreate. And so I'm going to show you an example of one of them that we're going to be recreating today, and just my thought process. So I saved that video because I instantly knew that I could do something similar from a business perspective. So let's dive in. This lady who created this TikTok, it was all about her relationships in her 20s and just all the mistakes that she made, or even like the struggles that she went through. And so my angle when I recreate this is probably going to be in the lens of me remembering what it was like being a solopreneur in my business and all the struggles that I had, all the mistakes that I made. And so this is one I definitely want to recreate. So that's just a little example of what I think of when I look through TikTok. And I really use TikTok videos as huge inspirations because TikTok is a more established platform than Instagram Reels. And I find that the people who create videos on TikTok are so much more creative so far than the ones that I'm seeing on IG Reels. And so that's kind of how I'm coming up with my content ideas. And so for today, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick maybe like 5 videos that I wanna recreate. I'm going to batch film them, and then afterwards, I'm going to edit them. All right, so once I found the video that I want to recreate, what I'm going to do is I'm going to film the video using the same sound. So on TikTok, you just click the video, you click the sound, and once you click the sound, you are going to be able to use sound, and you're also able to see other videos that have used that sound. So if you want even more inspiration on how other people are doing it versus the one that you liked, then you can do that as well. And I found that to be really helpful just to see how other people use the same audio. And it really helps, especially if you're not a creative person, just to see how you could do it for yourself. And so then we're going to hit this button where you can use the original sound. And now I'm gonna show you behind the scenes of me recreating this video. Now, one thing that you wanna know about Instagram Reels is, unlike TikTok, I believe TikTok you can go up to 60 seconds of footage, whereas on Instagram Reels, the max right now is only 15. So make sure you stay at the 15 second option. And when you're choosing sounds to create your IG Reels on, make sure that you know that you can only do 15 seconds of it. Otherwise, it would be a huge bummer if you did a full 60 second video and you couldn't even upload it on IG Reels. And so anyways, we are going to film this baby, and I'm gonna show you behind the scenes of what that looks like.
So right now I have everything set up. So I'm about to do my little dance for you guys, and you guys can see the behind the scenes. But before I start filming, I also want to give you guys a quick tip so that you can learn from a mistake that I made when I made my first IG Reels. And that is, especially if you're using TikTok to repurpose onto IG Reels, which is what I'm doing. And that's why earlier on in this video, I said that later on, I might do a dedicated video about IG Reels. But for now, I just really wanna show you guys the way that I do it and why I use TikTok. I'm gonna answer that question right now. I use TikTok instead of using IG Reels natively because I find that finding content on TikTok is a lot faster. I
like finding the sounds a lot faster. I think TikTok is a lot easier to use right now, and I just don't really see the harm in doing one content piece that you can repurpose on two platforms. So I'd rather expand my reach that way, even though for me, I don't really have a desire to be like a TikTok star or anything, but it just doesn't hurt to be on it, if you know what I mean, so why not? But anyways, one thing that you wanna be aware of, especially when you're filming your IG Reels, even if it's on TikTok and even if it's natively on IG Reels, is you have to understand that on Instagram Reels, there's basically two ways that you can see IG Reels. There's like two dimensions that you have to be aware of. The first dimension is the vertical dimension, where it's like 9x16, I think. And that's basically like an IG story, IGTV dimension. It takes up the full screen. And generally this shows up if you actually click on someone's IG Reel or if you're scrolling through the IG Reel like portal within Instagram and all that. So that's one way that you can watch IG Reels. The second way that most people watch IG Reels is if it's just through their feed or through someone's profile on their feed. And that dimension is, I believe, 4x5. And so what you have to realize is that I personally think most people are looking at it at the 4x5 dimension, because IG Reels is still really new. Not a lot of people have the patience to like click on something and then watch it. They're still scrolling through the regular feed, and the regular feed, the max dimension is 4x5. And so what that means is if you are filming a video on TikTok or even on IG Reels and you are like pointing to something right at the top, or you have text at the top, or you are super close to the screen, well, guess what? When someone actually looks at your IG Reel on your profile or on their home feed, it's gonna get cut out. Your 9x16 dimension is gonna get cut to 4x5, and anything outside of those dimensions will not show. And so that's a huge learning lesson that I got when I made my first IG Reel, and that's also why my first IG Reel took me so long to make, because I made that mistake and I took it down and I re-uploaded and all that stuff. Later on in this video, when we're editing my IG Reels, I'm gonna show you a hack on how you can tell whether or not something will be cut off. But for now, for the purpose of filming the IG Reel, here are some tips that I have for you. The first one is make sure you're not too close to the camera. You kind of want to be farther away so that if it does crop, it's not going to crop anything important like your face or your feet or whatever it is that you originally want in your IG Reel. Then the second thing that I have for you as a tip is if you are doing something where you're like, you know, pointing at text or dancing and whatnot, then you also want to make sure that if you're going to add text to the top, just be aware that it will get cut out if it doesn't fit the 4x5 dimension. And again, like I said, later on in this video when I'm editing, I'm going to show you how you can double check and make sure nothing will get cut out before you even post your content on IG Reels. But just know these are the things that you definitely want to keep aware of when you're filming. So that's why for me, when I'm filming my TikTok, I'm gonna be a little bit farther than I would like, and I'll be mindful of where I'm pointing and making sure I'm not pointing too high to the sky, because it will get cut out on Instagram. Now, as you can see, one thing that I also do is if I'm like not sure about a certain take and I kind of want to take it again, what I'll do is I'll just save it in my drafts, so that I'm not erasing the whole thing in case it really was the winning shot.
All right guys, so let's say you're done dancing and you're not sure if it's the winning dance, or maybe you don't wanna edit something right away. What you're going to do is you're gonna click next, and then instead of posting it right away to TikTok or saving it or anything else, you can just click drafts. And that way your video is saved to drafts, and when you go to your profile, you'll see an archive of all of the drafts that you've ever done over on your TikTok.
Okay, so I ended up liking the first version of the little pointing dance that I did, and I saved it in my drafts. So as you can see, it's already in draft mode. So what I like to do is I'm planning to just batch the filming process of everything, and then my next step after I'm done filming at least 5 IG Reels is then I'm going to edit. So just make sure you're utilizing the draft feature on TikTok, because it's so helpful just to save things and so that you can go back to it later and you don't feel pressured to want to finish the whole damn thing in one sitting. Hey guys, so just interrupting this video because I realized that you can also do drafts on IG Reels, and at the time that we're reviewing this video right now, I know that there's a possibility that TikTok could be banned, and so I definitely want to make sure you guys have everything you need to succeed also on IG Reels. And so on your Instagram, you're going to click on Reels, and you're gonna do your dance, you're gonna do whatever, you can still batch your content. So let's say you're doing your dance, look at my cute little cat ears and all that. Then afterwards, you're gonna click this button,
you're gonna
do your dance, you're gonna do whatever, you're gonna do your thing, edit. And before you even actually send it off to post it, if you're not ready and you just wanna batch your content, right at the bottom here, you're gonna be able to save as draft. And once it's saved as draft and you head over to your IG Reels, you're gonna see it in drafts. And that way you can click on this and you actually see all your drafts. So that's my very first IG reel that I tried testing out. And then you can edit your content later. So you can always, always batch your content, and you should never feel pressured to finish an entire IG reel in one sitting.
Okay, so now I'm just going through my TikTok likes again, and I wanna show you another video that I'm gonna be recreating, and it's this one.
It's time to boss up. Fix your credit, girl, get at it, get your bag up. Hit that gym and get back fine. Go get that degree, go girl, focus on me. Unlock potential that you didn't know you had it.
So I really love this video. I've seen this song used many times on TikTok, and generally it's like this crazy transition and it's all those things. For me, I just want to keep it simple. So I'm a fan of any video that doesn't require me to learn choreography, that doesn't require me to do any crazy outfit transitions. I'm not there yet. And so I feel like this one is doable. So let's do it. And I also like the message behind it. I really like how it's very empowering, and I definitely have a lot of lessons that I can share to people as well as I've gotten older, as I've gotten wiser in business. So I felt like this video would be perfect for me to recreate on Instagram Reels.
Oh my gosh, so this is my setup right now. This is the tripod on the desk, and I have the lyrics behind it so I don't mess up. And I put it in like super zoom out mode or zoom in mode so I can not mess up. And then of course the camera for this YouTube video right here. And then what I've done is, because this is like a boss video, I just like threw on sunglasses so I look bougier. I don't know. I might get hate for it. I have no idea for like putting sunglasses indoors. But yeah, and then I also changed my outfit. It's like literally also a black outfit, but I just felt like I wanted to be different and I didn't want to repeat the same outfit twice. And so I'm gonna be filming this You Got It video where I'm gonna share my lessons that I've learned in business. I don't know what I'm gonna do yet. So here's the thing, here's another tip when it comes to filming like IG Reels and the way that I do it is just film yourself doing the action. Don't care so much about the content, don't care so much about, oh, like, what's this text gonna have? What's the angle and all of that? Just film it and then figure it out later when you're editing, right? And so no matter what, it's still gonna be the same movements. It's still gonna be you lip singing. It's still gonna be you dancing, whatever that is. And then when you're in the editing process and you're adding text and you're figuring out the angle, that's when you can just decide what you actually want the content to be.
Get you and me, it's time to boss up. Fix your credit, girl, get at it, get your bag up. Hit that gym and get back fine. Go get that degree, go girl, focus on me. Unlock potential that you didn't know you had in you.
Okay, so I've selected the winner for video number 2, and now we're on to video number 3. I think for the purpose of this video, I'm only gonna show you 3 out of the 5 videos, just so that this video isn't super long. But as you can see, I did another outfit change. I am wearing like red top now. I don't know if you guys can see. And now I'm gonna select the next video that I want to recreate from my TikTok like videos. I already have this one in mind. It's like super easy to do and I think it's really funny. So let's watch it together.
Girl, don't do it. It's not worth it. I'm not gonna do it, girl. I was just thinking about it. I'm not gonna do it. I did it.
Okay, so basically I really like the sound of this video. The spin, the angle that I was thinking of doing is There's a lot of things that as a new entrepreneur, you say that you're not gonna do, but then you end up doing. And so I definitely think that I can make my own spin on this audio file. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do. So let's take you behind the scenes of me filming this video.
Okay, so with this one, it requires a little bit more pre-planning. I'm thinking my vision is like it's two people. One person is like the business coach or the mentor or whatever, AKA me, telling my client or my student not to do a certain thing. And then the second frame will probably be my client or student who's like, I'm not gonna do it, and then they're gonna do it. And the thing that they're gonna do is they're going to create a super fluffy niche statement on Instagram. This is something that I see a lot of people make a mistake on, and I think that this audio fits that situation perfectly, and so I'm gonna act this out.
Girl, don't do it. It's not worth it.
Okay, so that is person number one. And now I'm gonna switch outfits to be person number two. And so a little tip for you is just layer on so you don't have to change outfits all the time and spend all your time like taking your clothes off and putting it back on. So I'm just gonna put on this sweater, put on these glasses, and now there's a clear difference between person number one, which is the coach or the mentor, and then person number two, which is the student or the client.
I'm not gonna do it, girl. I was just thinking about it. I'm not gonna do it.
And then the third thing is I'm gonna need to do like a little green screen situation.
I did it.
And add a background to the video so that you can see exactly what the student did, which is the fluffy niche statement. So how I'm gonna do the green screen is I go to effects and then I'm gonna click this upload thing so that I can change the background. And that's kind of why I like to use TikTok, because I just feel like their features are a little bit more refined. And then I'll put the screenshot that I want, which is this one.
Girl, don't do it. It's not worth it. I'm not gonna do it, girl. I was just thinking about it. I'm not gonna do it. I did it.
Okay, so now we are down here on the floor because I have to charge my phone in order to show you guys how to edit these videos that we put in our drafts, simply because it requires a lot of battery. And so that's one thing you should know too, a little bonus tip, is if you're gonna batch Instagram Reel content or TikTok content or whatever it is, make sure your phone is fully charged. Mine wasn't, and it's been like literally hanging on by a piece of thread right now. And so we're gonna film the video here on the floor, and I'm gonna show you kind of the behind the scenes of what it looks like for me when I edit these videos. Okay, so when you are on my TikTok, it's gonna show that I have 5 drafts. And so when you click on the drafts, you'll then see all of your drafts by sound. And you'll notice that for the You Got It video, there's like 3 different variations of it because I did 3 takes and I wasn't sure which one I wanted, so I saved it all in drafts. And then I ended up choosing the one that I liked and I just changed the caption to this one. It's all in drafts, so as long as you don't publish it, you won't be able to see it. So if you have multiple drafts for one sound, you can just like quickly add notes for yourself to just remind yourself of which ones were like your top choices and stuff. Just for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna edit one of these videos just to show you how I do it, how I go from taking it to TikTok and then uploading it to Instagram Reels. And I feel like out of these 3 videos that I filmed today, the easiest one is probably the one that you just saw, which is the duo one with like me and the fake client and all that stuff. So we're gonna dive into editing that video and I'm gonna show you the behind the scenes of what that looks like. Okay, so what you're gonna do, and we're on the floor now, I'm actually like just sitting on the floor. Keep in mind that especially if you're reposting this to IG Reel, I feel like with Instagram, the caption is so generous. Like you could put so much context in. And so when you're doing IG Reels, just know that you can still write really long captions, just like how I did it in this video right here and all of that. And that's exactly my intention with this video. Okay, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to your drafts over on TikTok. We are gonna edit video right here. And what you're gonna wanna do once you hit the draft, you're gonna hit back. And that way you can edit the video. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna add text. The first person is gonna be me. I'm gonna make sure that it's not too high so that it still fits the 4x5 because I'm keeping that in mind. I'm gonna add another text
and this is gonna be new coaches or something. I'm just gonna put that slightly underneath. And it looks weird now, but what you're gonna actually do is you're gonna click on the text and you're gonna click set duration. And that way you can actually control when this sticker is gonna appear. And so I want the new coaches to appear around here when the second person shows up, and I want it to end around here. So you can see the little timestamps at the bottom and you can control all of that. Then I'm gonna hit this check mark. And now I'm gonna set the duration for the first text. And this is the first person that's in this TikTok. So then I'm gonna make sure that it disappears before the second person shows up. And I really like TikTok because you can kind of tell when to remove the text right around here. Then you're gonna hit check, and then you can watch the TikTok and see how it looks. And there you go. So that's how you add text quickly. And then you're gonna hit next. So the next step, and this is my hack on how I upload it to Instagram Reels and how I remove the TikTok logo, is what we're going to do is, first of all, we are gonna make sure that you have this function where you can record screen. So how you're gonna get this function is you're gonna wanna go to your settings, and this is really only applicable for Apple or iPhones. If you have an Android, there's probably an app that you can use to help you with this and to help you record screen. What you're gonna do is you're gonna click Control Center, Customize Controls, and you wanna make sure that in this Include section that you have screen recording. And how you're gonna usually find it if you don't have it is it's typically in more controls or something, and then you just move it up to include. Once you do that, you're gonna be able to scroll down on the top right-hand corner, and then you're gonna be able to activate the record button. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to TikTok, and we're gonna play the video and record it at the same time. So what you're gonna wanna do at this point is go down, hit record, and then play the video like this. Now, just for the purpose of this video, we're not gonna replay this entire thing, but just make sure you're recording the entire video on your screen. Once that's done and you're done the recording, you're gonna wanna hit photos. All right, and then once you enter your photo album, you're gonna find the recording that you just did. In my case, it looks like this. You're gonna hit edit, and there's gonna be two steps that you're gonna wanna take. The first step is you're gonna want to just edit out all the screen flow stuff and only isolate the parts that you want. So for in my case, I just want this part up until the end of the TikTok, which is around here. Then what you also wanna do, and notice how there's no TikTok logo. So this is my hack, because when you screen record it right from drafts, TikTok doesn't put their watermark in it yet. But the next step that you wanna do is you wanna hit this button right here where you can actually crop. Just find the part of the video that actually matters to you, and you're gonna wanna crop out the black squares or the black frame. Then you're gonna hit done, save video. Now you have a perfect video with no watermark whatsoever that allows you to put it onto IG Reel. So let's do that together. We're gonna go onto Instagram. Now here's the little hack though. Before I even upload to IG Reels, I first wanna make sure that the text won't be cut off if someone is looking at my IG Reels at the 4x5 view, kind of like here, the 4x5 view right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pretend like I'm uploading it to my Instagram on the original feed. I'm going to select the video that I want to upload, and then I'm gonna hit this expansion button. And after you hit that expansion button, it's gonna show you what it's gonna look like when it's uploaded to your feed at the 4x5 dimension. And so luckily for me, nothing is cut off with my IG Reel. On the other hand, for this IG Reel that I did in the past, when I hit the expansion button, you'll notice that things are actually cut off. And that's when I know that this isn't usable for IG Reels. So once you've determined whether or not it fits within the 4x5 dimension, then you can upload it to IG Reels, in which case you would hit this button right here, kind of like as if you were gonna do your stories. Then on the third option, you're gonna hit Reels, and then you can upload it.
Girl, don't do it, it's not worth it.
Once you've uploaded it, then you can hit next, and then you can set your cover. So whatever you would like here, you could add your caption, and once you're happy with it, you can then hit share, and it'll automatically be posted onto your IG Reel feed and your main feed as well. And so here is the end result of this IG Reel. As you'll see, it looks good with the full dimension, and it also looks good when people see it on the original feed as well. So that's my little hack on how to make sure everything is gonna be visible on your original feed, and also how to remove that pesky TikTok logo, especially if you're migrating content from TikTok to Instagram Reels.
So far in this video, you kind of saw the entire behind the scenes of me batching some of my IG Reel content, how I do it. I know it's not perfect, so don't come for me in the comment section. I'm still really trying to figure out IG Reels, but I figured that I would rather have this YouTube video up for you guys so that you have the information on how I do it at least. And then over time, as I perfect my methods, as I use IG Reel natively instead of using TikTok, let's say, I can then post a more formal video about my true thoughts on IG Reels. But again, I would much rather you guys have the true, you know, behind the scenes look of how I do my content on IG Reels. So far for me, it's given me pretty good results in terms of reach, and the way that I've done it hasn't hurt anybody, hasn't hurt me, and so I'm gonna keep doing this way until there's a better way. And once there is a better way to do things, I will let you guys know in a future video. Now, while you wait for next week's video, I post a lot of videos on social media, marketing, coaching, entrepreneurship, all the likes of that. So make sure you check out these two videos that I have right here as well. As always, guys, I appreciate you. I hope you guys have a great day, a great week, and a great life, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys!